I'm scared out of my wits. I hate it every second. I'm just glad it's over.
Finish it on the rock.
The big!
It was a big bag of bananas. It was a lot of fun. A little scared out there on a step, but that's beside the point.
It was awesome. The first time when I was walking through the first beam, I saw it shake a little bit. I was a little worried, but I kept on going. But it was great. Take it.
I was scared more than anything. I'm afraid of heights, and that thing looks about 50 feet up in the air when you're out there. I didn't think I was going to make it for a while.
And those shark fins.
Yeah, those stairs seem like they're about 3 feet high out there. It was okay, though.
Who's the best platoon out here? That's what I'm talking about.
Good morning, I'm Lieutenant Bob Sewell. Basically, what's going on here today, cadets are receiving a brief familiarization with the medium girder bridge, which is a British bridge. They're receiving instruction on this, not primarily because they want to be engineers, just to evaluate their leadership skills. The squad leaders, which you see in the background, are actually constructing the bridge without any help from my cadre, and they're informing them troops how to construct that bridge. And we receive evaluation skills. We evaluate the cadre on the skills they received and the training they received here at West Point.
So, your time to beat, a time it's going to be hard to beat, too. 16 minutes and 15 seconds. Set last night by 5th Company, 3rd Platoon, 1st Squad.
Nothing
to you, right?
What's that? 12
minutes.
What
are they doing different?
We were kind of disrupted.
Hell!
Come on.
It's set.
Lay hold.
Wednesday!
Lay hold.
Thank you.
I'm Lieutenant Bob Sewell. With cadets are receiving training on today is the Assault Float Bridge Ribbon. What the cadets will be doing is actually constructing this bridge with help from my cadre members. Once they receive this instruction, the cadets will actually build this float bridge themselves.
Belly flop! Ah! So tell us about your Camp Buckner experience so far.
It's been really good. Been out in the field all this week. Learned a lot during land nav. Some squad training. It's been good. Oh, I have been camoing up and low crawling through the swamp and all that good stuff. Of Camp Buckner, and we're having a terrific time here.
There we are. Jennifer Dan from 4th Company, 4th Platoon.
3rd Platoon, go Hammers!
Go, man!
Come on, you California pickers!
Hold on, okay? Keep it up there! Keep it up there! Mike Stoney!
I'm sorry.
Hello. My name is Pepper Ingram from Company A1, 4th Company CFT. The best thing about being here is the HUA infantry training.
I'm Mike Keown. I'm in Pepper's company, Company A1, second company out here. Most exciting thing I'm gonna do this summer, I may be going home, but I don't want to because this is the place to be.
Hello, I'm Anne-Marie Johnson. I'm in Company B1. Here I'm in 7th Company. The best thing about here is just the experience of doing nothing you've ever done before.
I'm James Orff. I'm in Echo 1 out here. I'm in 4th Company, and it's just exciting being here and the infantry stuff that we do.
All right.
Coop!
Hey, Cooper!
My name's Gilbert Barrera, Company 5, and this summer we're doing some high-speed, motivated ranger training, doing some night land nav, day land nav, and if you're not careful, you can get lost real quick, but it's some high-speed training. We've been out on the field for a whole week, and just got back last night at 1:30 in the morning.
Yeah, it was really good stuff. The navigation, you gotta really know your terrain. They stress the compass, but I think the terrain's more important with the way it is here. And we also discovered about the historical 809th Pennsylvania Lightning Infantry Division. And it was a division that did the Sicilian airdrop during World War II. And it was deactivated after World War II, and we reinvented it. And our 3rd Squad, 4th Platoon, 5th Company is called the 809. And we're the most motivated platoon there is.
Yeah, let's hear a little motivation, 809. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
809!
Pennsylvania Lightning.
That's my man Rhett for the burgers.
Price Five.
Wait! No, I'm gonna go get it. Say hi, Mom. Say hi, Mom.
Yeah, number one.
Go third, go. Hi, Mom.
Are you ready for qualification? Those little suckers ain't got no chance, do they? Y'all ready to blast a few holes in them? Are you sure? How many holes? All right, listen up. Still flash back on.
Yeah, this time, Curtis Gray is going to be posted within you alongside the fire.
Not bad. Oh, you pulled this one.
I think you sure you pulled that one. I bet that was your first round, because first round's always worse.
Is it really? Is
it not? If you would have counted that one, that would have been 15.
I could just put one in the middle and down here on all five of us.
Afternoon.
afternoon. My name is Lieutenant Flack. I'm the OIC of Range 4. This is familiarization range on the M72A2 LOL, the M203 40mm grenade launcher, and the M18A1 anti-personnel mine, better known as the Claymore. What we do is we break the cadets up into their three squads and send them to each of our three stations. There they receive approximately 30 minutes of training, and then they go out on the firing line on the M72A2 LAW, where they fire five subcaliber rounds. On the M203 range, they fire three HE rounds and two TPT rounds. And on the Claymore, they go down and use mock-up Claymores in order to set them up and recover them. Culmination of that, we bring them down to our LAW range, and they'll fire one live Claymore and one live LAW so that they'll have a demonstration of that, and that basically culminates the training.
Talk me through it as you go.
I want to check all the openings to make sure the prongs aren't messed up.
Checking the wire, make sure the blasting cap's intact. And the prongs were clear from dirt and air.
Okay, what do you never want to do that blasting cap?
Never want to touch it.
Exactly.
Tied it off, Doc, and
test
it.
You gotta have it under
center. I'm gonna wire back down, range your stake.
In case you accidentally blast it.
Yeah, that's just my wire. You need to get down, you need to test the wire.
Okay. Continue on down range.
You got that blaster cap there.
Never leave your firing device in your position, okay?
Okay.
Reason being,
flame on mine, right? I'm gonna bring this up because there's mine up down there. Somebody comes behind you.
So you want to avoid touching that, remember?
I'm a number two.
Okay.
So you're on the one left?
Yeah, come on.
Now open the barrel about 1 to 2 inches at first. And then just slide, just grab the round. As you slide the barrel open, just grab the round. Just catch it as it falls out. Yeah, be sure to catch it. You don't want it to fire out like that. You could explode it all over you. You don't want that to happen. Then once you have the round, just place it down in front of you. Make sure the weapon's on safe at this time. And then simply return the barrel to the fore position. Any questions on how to unload this weapon? How to unload a round? Everybody get back up. Grab your round. By this time, reload your round. You don't seem like anything over there, Dan. You seem like. So once you have that weapon loaded, make sure you have it loaded. Just return the barrel back to this forward position.
Put this round.
So once again, with one hand cupped underneath, get your thumb and depress the barrel latch. And then just ride the barrel forward and catch the round as it comes out. Once again.
If you want to hit like this side of it.
When you have expended all five rounds, lock and clear your weapons. Then place the weapons on the firing wall, leaning them against it. At this time, the firers will become...
Nate, you don't have your finger on the trigger. There you
clear the weapon. Lean it against the firing wall in front of you.
Backbluster, clear!
Backbluster, clear!
Place it on safe. Make sure you place it on safe when you bring up shots. The defense.
Blackbuster, clear!
Blackbuster, clear!
Blackbuster, clear!
Blackbuster, clear! Hey!